Welcome to this brief guide on how to use filter views in Google Sheets. Let's face it, working with massive spreadsheets can be a bit of a nightmare. Endless rows and columns, struggling to locate that one crucial piece of information, it's enough to make anyone want to tear their hair out. And let's not even talk about collaborating with others when everyone's making changes and it's impossible to keep track of anything. But fear not, because Google Sheets has a powerful solution to rescue you from spreadsheet chaos, and it's called filter views. In this tutorial, we'll walk through everything you need to know to master filter views and transform your Google Sheets experience. First up, let's create a filter view. This allows you to save specific filter settings, your sorted columns, hidden rows, and any conditions that you've applied. It's like capturing a snapshot of your filtered data, ready to be accessed whenever you need it. So first things first, open up your spreadsheet. Then head over to the Data tab in the toolbar and click on Create Filter View. Think of this like setting up a new camera angle for your project data, a personalized view just for you. Now let's say we want to focus on tasks that are assigned to me that haven't been started yet. To do this, we'll click on the filter icon in the Assigned To column header. This opens up a menu where we can select who we want to see tasks from. Let's click on Clear and then just select Paul O'Malley. Click OK, and now we've narrowed down our view to just my tasks. Next, let's filter by progress status. Click the filter icon in the progress status column. Again, select clear and then specifically check not started. Click OK and voila. Now we're only seeing tasks that are assigned to me that haven't been started. This is pretty easy to do and something that we do on a regular basis. But now that we have our filter set up, let's save this view so that we can easily access it later. See that Save View button in the top right corner next to the X? Go ahead and give that a click. A small window will pop up where we can give our view a descriptive name. Let's call this one Paul's Tasks. Once you've entered the name, go ahead and click the Save button. Now, this filtered view is saved and ready to be used whenever we need it. Now let's say we want to quickly create a similar view for another team member, David Lee. Instead of starting from scratch, we can simply duplicate our existing filter view and make a few tweaks since it's going to be very similar. To do this, click on the ellipsis menu over in the top right of the filter view. This opens up a menu with some handy options. Go ahead and select Duplicate View to create a copy of our current view. While we're here, let's also rename this view to David's Tasks. Again, we can do this using that same ellipsis menu. Now, we just need to adjust the filter for the assigned person. Click the filter icon in the Assigned To column and uncheck Paul O'Malley, and instead check David Lee. Click OK and there we have it. This view now shows only David's not started tasks. To go back to our main table view, just hit the X icon in the top right corner. Now that we have our view set up, let's see just how easy it is to switch between these different perspectives. Go up to your Data tab in the toolbar and then select Change View. You'll see our saved views listed here. Select Paul's Tasks to instantly see the tasks that are assigned to me that I have not yet started. Now, let's say we need to check on David's progress. Simply go back to Data and then Change View, and this time select David's Tasks. Just like that, we're now looking at David's outstanding tasks. This is incredibly helpful for presentations or analysis when you need to quickly jump between pre-configured views without manually needing to adjust the filters every single time. But what's even more powerful is how these filter views can greatly enhance collaboration. Think about it. In a shared spreadsheet, if everyone's constantly adjusting filters, it can become a real mess. you might lose your carefully crafted view or accidentally disrupt someone else's work since we're all working on the same live spreadsheet. Filter views specifically solves for this problem. Each person can create and work within their own filter views without affecting the underlying data or anyone else's views. It's like having your own personal workspace within the shared spreadsheet. This means no more filter conflicts, no more stepping on each other's toes, and a much smoother collaborative experience. Personally, I've been using filter views in Google Sheets for this specific benefit ever since I first learnt about them. No longer do I have to worry about what filtering anyone else is doing to the spreadsheet and can instead focus on my own work. I can also be confident that I'm not messing up their work either. Now let's say that you want to share a specific filtered view with a colleague. Instead of having them recreate all of your filters, you can actually share a direct link to your view. To do this, go to the Data tab in the toolbar and click on View Options. Here, you'll see an option that says Get Link to View. Click on that and it'll copy a link to your current filter view, ready to be pasted into an email, chat, or document. Let's see this in action. I'll open up a new browser tab here and paste in that link. When I hit enter, it'll take me straight to the spreadsheet and automatically filter to that saved view. This is super useful when you want to showcase a very particular set of filtered data without having to explain each and every filter to the recipient. But what about when you are finished with your filter views and you want to start fresh? No problem, because Google Sheets makes it easy to delete them too. Simply head back to the Data tab in the toolbar and click on View Options again. Here, you'll see options to either delete the current view or delete all views in the tab at once. This allows you to easily clean up your spreadsheet and remove old filter views that are no longer needed. It's great for when you're finished with one project and don't want these excess views taking up space in the menus. And congratulations! You've now mastered the art of filter views in Google Sheets. Remember, filter views are your key to efficient project management, collaboration, and organization. So experiment, explore, and unlock the full potential of your spreadsheets today, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.